Everyone, you are welcome to Geojay Solution Tutorial Channel. I am Peter Emanje Adaviruku. Today, I want to show you how to show multiple maps in a single layout in ArcGIS. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you. So in ArcGIS, for example, I've loaded in my data, and in this data, I have land use land map for series of years. I have it for 1990. This is the 1990 land use land cover for this area. And this is for year 2000. This is for year 2010. And this is for year 2020. So these four epochs, if I want to show them on a single map, how can I do that? Now, to do that, you have to add a frame. Because if you go to layout, for example, you see only one layout where you can add all the maps. But if you want to add these multiple maps in this single layout, to do that, you come back here. You can come on your data view, come to insert, click on insert. You see data frame. So you insert new empty data frame. So now we have four epochs and we already have one frame. It means we are going to add three more frames to this one. So to do that, come to insert and click on data frame. We have added new data frame. Click on it again, add one more. Then the last one, click on it and add the last one. So what it means is that you are going to copy. Now let's assume you want to leave this first one to be for 1990. Then you move 2000, move it here under here. 2010, you move it under this frame. Then year 2020, you move it under this last one. So now it therefore means that you all have to uncheck these ones, then come to your layout view. Come to layout view, so you can see multiple frames. So you have to drag them to arrange them. We have four of them. Now we have four of them. So for us to know which one is which, what to do is that you select one. For example, this one, you highlight it, come to insert and click on legend. Click on legend and click on next, click on next, click next, click next, click finished. So now it's showing us the legend for this one. This is for year 2000. Year 2000. Remember, you created it for this. So you bring it here. You can now adjust it. It's for this. Then you come for this one, highlight it, come to insert, legend, click next, 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 and finished. So it has created for you this 2010. Bring it here. Then click on this, highlight this frame, come to insert, legend, click next, 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 finished. So bring it here. Then this last one, click on it, come to insert, legend. So it is the 1990. So click next, 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 finished. So adjust it. So it's for this. So this is what it means. You'll be able to identify each one. And based on how you want to arrange it, you'll be able to arrange it. Now, let's arrange it serially. So, I want my 1990 to come first. But before then, let's add knit line. Click here and draw a knit line here like this. Okay, then right click, go to properties. this fill color, choose no color. Then outline color, let's just choose black and increase the width, let's say 5, and click on OK. Yes, so this first one, I want it to be here, and I will adjust it. I'll bring its legend over here and adjust it. Then this is 1990. Then this is year 2000. This year 2000, I'll bring it here. And the legend, I'll bring it here. And I will adjust. So I will adjust and do the same for this. I will adjust, bring the final one also here and arrange the legend. I'll bring it here. So haven't arranged it like this, then you can come to each of the layer like this one and right click and zoom to layer. So to zoom it to layer, then you can adjust your legend. Right click it, go to properties, and you can make it bold and increase the size as you want and click on OK. So likewise this, for this, you come here, zoom to layer, this one also, zoom to layer, and finally this, zoom to layer. So we can see, this is 99, year 2000, year 2010, and year 2020. So you have arranged it now. Now the next thing to do now is to come here, right click this one and add the grids. To add grids, right click, click on the properties, then come to grids. This is grid. Add new grids and click next. You want to label only, and the interval should be 1 degree. Click next, and click on finish. Then you can apply and see what you've done. You can see it here, but it look like 1 degree is too spacious. So you can come back to properties, click on properties. Instead of one, let's say 2 degree, here 2 degree. Then come to label, make it left, right, and here you can adjust this, let's say 10, for instance. Click OK and apply. Okay, it's too spacious. Can go back to properties. It's go to intervals. So instead of 2, let's say 0, 0, but 30 minutes. 30 minutes, for instance, and click on OK, apply. Okay, I think it's better like this. So you have done for this. Likewise, this one. Right click, go to properties, then go to new grid and click next. Label only, instead of 1 degree, let's say 0, 0, but here 30 minutes, 30 minutes. Click next, next, finished. Then apply and go to properties again and come to label and make it 10. Cambod left, right, click OK. Okay, it's done. And do the same for the remaining two. For the last one, this one, right click again, go to properties, come to new grid and click next, label lonely. This is 0 degree, 0 degree, 30 minutes. Click next, next, finish. Apply. Go back to properties and labels. Make it 10. Left, right. Okay. Okay. So you can see it now. Now for the legend, you can adjust it as you wish. For the legend, let's say for the legend, come to the items. What is the size? The size you want it to be. Let's say 10 and make it bold. Click OK and see. So it's too much. So let's make it 8. Right click and go to properties again. Make it 8. Click OK. It's still too much. So you do it until you achieve a perfect map. 6. Yes, I think this is okay. This is okay. Or you can adjust it a little bit. Another way to do it is just to click it and drag to expand it. Or right click and go to properties, make it bold and choose the size that is applicable. Like this, then you can now adjust it small to make it fit in to your map. Another thing you can do, okay, let's finish the remaining one. Make it bold, 6. Okay, so and adjust it. So I think it's okay now. So the remaining thing now is your scale. So to put scale, highlight the frame where you want to put the scale, right click it and come to insert and add scale. So you choose scale bar, choose the one you want to put and click on OK. So it has been inserted. So what you can just leave it in mice or you adjust it depending on your needs or your preference. So likewise, if you want to insert scale on this one, highlight it, go to insert and click on scale. Choose this one and click on OK. Take it to where you want it to be. Then likewise this one, make sure you highlight the frame where you want to put the items. This one as well, bring it down. Since they are the same study area, the same map, the same extent, you can copy and paste. However, it's better you do it for it, for them one by one. Scale. Bring it down. So now, remaining one thing, not arrow. So since it is just a single frame covering all, come to insert, you see not arrow. Choose any of your symbol, any of the symbol, and click on OK. So this is it, and bring it to where you want it to be. So our map is ready. Now you can now export it. To export it, come to export, export map, and wait for it in this. Okay, you can now label it as example map. Example map. Choose your format and your resolution and click on save. So in few seconds your map will be saved. So it has been saved. Now we can now go to our exercise folder where you save it. We save it as example map. This is it. Then double click to open. Let's open the map and see how it looks like. So it's coming up. Yes, this is our map. You can see now we have four maps, four epoch on a single frame, single layout. So you can see 1990, year 2000, if you come down, 2010, and 2020. So on a single view, you can see the four epochs at one time. So this is how to show multiple maps on a single layout in ArcGIS. Please subscribe to this channel, like our video, share. Thank you for watching.